today we're going to discuss solutions on sample problems here. Okay, so to start with, so here is the three-moment equation. So this would be the three-moment equation, M1 L1 plus 2M2 L1 plus L2 plus M3 L2 plus the 6AA over L1 plus 6AB over L2 equals 6EI H1 over L1 plus H3 over L2. So three-moment equation is applicable for every 3 points. No, it could be 3 points or it could be 2 spans at a time for a given beam. Then if H1 and H3 are the settlements or the deflections or the movements of the supports relative to the middle support. Okay, so if the left support, H1, if the left support doesn't yield or doesn't settle with respect to the middle support, H1 would be 0. Likewise, if H3 or support 3 doesn't yield or doesn't settle, okay, so H3 would be equal to 0 with respect to the middle support also. So that's our equation becomes this one. Okay, so again, three-moment equations are applicable in 2 ways. It could determine deflections of determinate beams. So, katulad din ng other methods that we have discussed before, pwede rin siyang magamit in determining deflections for determinate beams. Or, pwede rin siyang magamit to analyze indeterminate beams. Katulad din ng virtual work method, okay, or yung method of consistent deformation, pwede rin gamitin yung three-moment equation sa indeterminate beams by solving the support reactions and moments. Okay, so today, I'm going to discuss an example or solve an example wherein we are asked to solve for the deflection at the free end, C, point C here, okay, of the beam shown. The elasticity is 200 GPa, so this is made of steel, and the inertia is 50 million mm to the fourth. Okay, so again, we have a simple beam with overhang. The length between supports is 9 meters, and the overhang length is 3 meters, and it has to carry a load of 5 kN downward at point C. So again, we're asked to determine for this deflection delta at point C. Now, so we can make use of this three-moment equation considering span. Okay, span ABC. Okay, span ABC. Okay, so with the application of the three-moment equation, so this would be MA, okay, L1 plus 2MB L1 plus L2, so this one, plus MC, the third point, okay, so L2, plus the 6AA over L1, plus the 6AB over L2, since, okay, is equal to 6EI. Now, ano yung H1? H1 is the settlement or the deformation of point A in relation to middle support point B. Since both hinge and roller supports doesn't yield, hindi sila nagsasettle, hindi sila nagde-deflect, diba? The positions of points A and B are of the same point before and after loading, therefore this H1 would be 0. Okay, so yung H sa A over L1 would be just 0. Plus, ano yung H3? H3 would be the H dun sa point C over L2. Okay, yung HC rito, this would correspond to the deflection, the settlement or the movement of joint C in relation to the middle support B. Okay, so substituting values, MA moment at A is 0, right? So this would be 0. So 0 plus 2, MB is the moment there. L1 is 9 meters, so 9 plus L2 is 3 meters plus MC. What's the moment at C? Diba 0 siya kasi dulo siya ng beam. So this would just be 0. So 0 plus, so we have this 6AA over L1. Okay? Plus the 6AB over L2 is equal to 6EI times, this is 0 because the deflection of point A with respect to the B is 0, while the deflection of point C, deflection of point C with respect to B is actually delta. So delta over L1, L2 is 3. Okay, so that this would be our equation, three moment equation. Okay, so from this three moment equation, we have to look for the AA and the AB here. So let's have the 6AA over L1. So paano ba sinosolve yung 6AA over L1? Now, paano ba pagkuha ng AA? What do you mean by AA? A is the statical moment of area, meaning we need to get or copy the length 1, L1. So, copyin ko. So, paano ba sinosolve yung AA? So, copyin mo yung length 1. Okay, this one. So, 9 meters siya. Tapos, make it simple beam. Lagi mo siyang gawing simply supported. Irregardless ko anuman ang supports na meron dito sa real beam natin, when you solve for AA, just copy the length and make it a simple beam. Tapos copyin yung load. So as you can see, for this, wala namang load. So therefore, the reaction would be 0. The reaction would be 0 since walang load. Therefore, yung AA natin would be just be 0. So therefore, our 6AA over L1 would be 0. Okay, now what about for this 6AB over L2? 6AB over L2. Okay, let's say, ano muna yung AB? A times B. O, kopyahin yung L2. So, yung L2 natin is yung 3 meters. So, kopyahin yung L2, which is 3 meters. Gawing simply supported ulit. Tapos, copyahin ko ano yung load doon. So, ang load natin dito is yung 5 kilonewton, which is here. 5 kilonewton. Then, due to that 5 kilonewton, ano nangyari? So, the reaction here would be also 5 kilonewton. The reaction here would be 0. Okay? So, pagka nag-drawing ako ng moment diagram by parts, pagka nag-reference ako dito, anong diagram ko? 0, wala. So, no area. So, since wala akong area na nag-generate, therefore, my AB would be 0, and it follows that yung 6AB over L2 ko would be just 0. So, I'm showing here that this would be 0, this would be also a 0. Okay? Okay. Now, we have a sign convention on H1 and H2. So from this, no? So ano ulit yung sign convention natin? Okay, so our sign convention for this H1 and H3 is that H would be positive if the settlement is downward. So again, yung sign convention natin sa H1 and H3, it would be positive kapag yung settlement would be downward. Downward settlement. And it would be negative kapag upward yung settlement. Okay? So meaning, when we go back here, yung delta rito, since ang settlement ng point C is pababa with respect to B, pababa. So therefore, our HC would be positive. So kaya positive to. Okay. So solving for this equation na. So this would be our three moment equation. So simplifying this. So this would be, simplify. Okay. So we'll have 2 MB times 9 plus 3 is 12. Okay? Is equal to 6 EI delta over 3. Okay, but EI is given. Elasticity and inertia were given. So let us substitute there. So this becomes 24 MB. Okay? So, anong unit nitong 24 MB na to? MB say is in kilonewton meter. Then this is distance, 9 and 3 meters. So the unit of this 3 MB is kilonewton meter square. Okay, 6. Elasticity is 200 GPa. Let's say 200 GPa is 200 kilonewton per mm square. Okay. Then inertia is 50. Say 50 times 10 to the 6. This is mm to the 4th. Okay, so this is mm square. Cancel with this. So what happens here is kilonewton mm square. To be consistent with this kilonewton mm square, so I have to convert this mm square with meter square. Okay, so 1 meter square is just equal to 1,000 square. So, kaya naging kilonewton meter square na siya, consistent with the kilonewton meter square on the left side. Then, times the delta over 3. 3 is expressed in meters, so therefore, I am expecting that my delta here is expressed in meters also. Okay, so calculating for this one. Now, we have two unknowns here, no? So, MB and delta. But what is MB? MB is the moment at point B. So, we can solve easily the moment at B by cutting sections. So, if I cut the section here, the moment at B would be 5 times the moment arm of 3. So, 5 times 3. And that would be 15. Kilonewton meter. Now, what is the true sign of this moment at B? Diba, the moment there would be in this direction. Okay, in that direction. So, this direction, this clockwise direction of moment makes this beam sad face, diba? So, sad face. So, therefore, this would be negative. Negative kasi sad face. So, substituting it here, our equation becomes 24 times negative 15 here is equal to 6 times 200, then times 50 times 10 to the 6 divided by the 1000 square conversion factor times delta over 3. So, from here, the delta will be 24 times negative 15, okay, so times this times 1000 square divided by 6 divided by 200 divided by 50 million, okay, times this 3. Therefore, the deflection is negative 0.018 meters. So that means negative. So in millimeters, that 18 millimeters. So the negative there means downward. So that is the answer already. 18 millimeter downward. Okay? So I hope you understand this solution for my first sample problem here. Okay, so